Good afternoon to you, my fellow students, wherever you want to follow these lectures from, in different parts of the country and even in different parts of the world. Today we are going to be working on Cameroon history, which is paper 2 in advanced level history. We'll be working mostly with paper 2. We know that advanced level history has paper 1. We have paper 1. We have 50 multiple choice in paper 1. Paper 2 is all about Cameroon history. And then paper 3, we talk about Africa and world history. Africa and world history. Now, in paper 1, in advanced level history, 50 multiple choice will be answering. 20 of those 50 multiple choice will come from Cameroon history. Why 15 will come from Africa history and 15 will come from world history. Now, paper 2, we will be talking more of Cameroon history. Paper 2 is all about Cameroon history, which is divided into section A. Section A, section B, and section C. Section A, in the GCE, you will be given 4 questions to choose one and answer. Section B, you also be given 4 questions to choose one and answer. Section C, you'll be given 4 questions to choose one and answer. All gives you 3. Then your number 4 questions will be a question that you are going to select from any of the sections that is favorable to you. Then you answer it to give you 4 essay questions in the history paper 2. Now, what we need to know is that we have to understand that there are topics in Section A that we must have a good mastery of these topics, that for over the years, the GCE has always included in the paper 2. We have first one, we have population movement. You need to have a mastery of population movement in the 19th century Cameroon. Then, aside population movement, we also have to have a mastery of state and kingdoms in Cameroon. We talk about the jihads again. We talk about Christian missionaries, and we talk about the scramble for Cameroon and German penetration. These topics are mentioned about 5. We should be rest assured we are going to see 2 essay questions out of the 4 in this session that are going to come from these topics. Again, still in that section A, we also have to have a good mastery of First World War in Cameroon, a mastery of the condominium and the partition of Cameroon. That is where Section A ends. In Section B, we have to know that Section B, you need to know the technicalities of how questions are being said. Because if you cannot have a mastery of how and where they said, you'll not be able to know how to answer questions. In Section B in Cameroon history, we need to know that 4 questions are going to come. And out of the 4 questions, know that a question is going to come from the mandate in British Cameroon. We should be talking about the mandate in British Cameroon. We talk about the administration of Southern Cameroon as integral part of Nigeria. We look at reasons why Southern Cameroon was administered as part of Nigeria. We look at the consequences. Again, under mandate, we look at the terms of the mandate and to the extent to which the British respected the terms of the mandate that were given to them by the League of Nations to administer Southern Cameroon. We look at indirect role under mandates. We look at native authorities. Those are the areas we are going to look at under mandate. Now, still in Section B, in British Southern Cameroon, we have to talk about, again, trusteeship. Trusteeship in British Southern Cameroon. Under trusteeship, we will be looking at constitutional development in British Southern Cameroon from 1922 right up to 1954. When we look at the 1942, we are going to look at the Hugh Clifford Constitution. We look at the Otto-Richard Constitution 1946. We look at the Macpherson Constitution of 1951. And we end with the Oliver Lyttelton Constitution of 1954. Still under the trusteeship, we will look at the Eastern Regional Crisis in May 1953 in Nigeria. We look at the rise of EMN Endele to power as premier in British Southern Cameroon in 1954.
we look at the organization of a plebiscite in British Southern Cameroon. We look at the why Fonsha became prime minister in British Southern Cameroon. Those are some of the areas in trusteeship in British Southern Cameroon we are going to look at. Now, in the paper two, or in section B, one question out of four is going to come from mandate in British Southern Cameroon. Another question is going to come from the trusteeship in British Southern Cameroon. Same in with French Cameroon. The mandate in French Cameroon is going to give us one question. Why trusteeship in French Cameroon is going to give us another question. It will give us four. So, as a student, you already need to be aware that in section B, Cameroon history, you should know that you have a question in the mandate in British Southern Cameroon that you are going to see in paper two. You have another question in trusteeship that is going to come. That gives us two questions. Another number three question will come from the mandate in French Cameroon, and number four will come from the trusteeship in French Cameroon. It gives us four questions. In section C, we will be looking at the history of Cameroon from 1961, from the federal constitution right up to the new Dzi government of President Paul Biya, which therefore means that here in section C, we will look at the Bamenda All Party Conference, we look at the Fumban Constitutional Conference, we look at the KNDP crisis in British Southern Cameroon, we look at the government of Auguste Ngongjua as prime minister in the state of West Cameroon, we go ahead, we look at the implementation of a one-party state in Cameroon in 1966, we look at why the federal system of government was abolished, or the federation was abolished to a unity state in 1972. We look at the resignation of Ahidjo as president in 1982. Then we enter the unity government of Paul Biya, where we look at the euphoria, the coming to Biya of Tupa and Cameroonian celebrating, and other topics. That is how a rundown of the program is going to be. So, we are going to just look into population movement. Let's just have a good or a deep revision of what population movement is all about, because for over the years, this is a topic that is always fatal and has always been appearing in the paper. Now, population movement, what can we really define population movement?